Hey guys, it's Kimmie here. I wanted to show you my finished bookmark for Suzie's challenge over at Mixed Media Vintage Arts. I wanted to show you a little bit of the detail because sometimes you can't see it all in pictures and make a video for my YouTube. But anyways, I'm going to show you what I did. The back is the same as the front. I used a Tim Holtz letter stamp, and I just distressed the edges with gathered twigs, brushed corduroy, tea dye, antique linen, and then frayed burlap, and that's how I got this like dirty, like Sammy likes to say, run through the mud edge, and background right here. So it started out white cardstock. I stamped on it and then grunged it up. Then I took my black slip distress ink and I went all along the edge and I doubled up some chipboard right here. I don't know if you can see. So, and then I used some grunge board and cut out some of the gadget gears, and then I took and I grunged them up with some of the, I used rusty hinge, and then I went over and I just went around the edges of it with, tea dye, gathered twigs, and I want to say brushed corduroy, and then I took some black soot on my finger and just inked the embossing where I took and I ran it through my cuddle bug and embossed it with some embossing folders, and I did that on all of them. And then this stamp right here is from Graphic 45 from the, what is it? Something debutantes. I can't think of the name. I'll think of it and I'll tell you. And then this right here is paper from the Donna Salazar's Antiquities collection that I inked up and everything. This was white paper that I stamped with my stamp set, and it says Journey. And I also used the Adventure from that same stamp set. And this tag is from DCWV's, what's it called? Tattered Time. And then I used some Wild Orchid Craft flowers that I took and I glimmer mist and I Lindy's'd. And then this one here is actually one of my own sparkle mist that I made. I took some old vintage beads from my vintage jewelry finds that I find at the swap meets and stuff, and that's what this right here is also. It was a necklace pendant that I found at the swap meet, and I thought it was really cool to go right there. And then I added some charms up here. This is from the Marion Smith's trinket collection right here. This is just a brass flower charm that I found online on eBay. And then this was an old necklace right here, another swap meet find of mine that is just all old and tarnished and brown, so I thought it'd be cool to put on here because it's the challenge was to make a grunge bookmark. So I just broke that necklace up and I used it to hold my charms and everything and put it right there. And then I took and I tea dyed some sheer ribbon and I tied it in a bow right there, and then I got some jute rope there. And that is my, let me see if I can give you and all over. This is my mess. My desk started out clean. Look at that, you guys. Okay, look at my mess. This is my creative process. Okay, so anyways, let me see if I can give you a better view. Okay, so that is how my bookmark turned out. Oh, and this. Okay, I see online and everything, everybody using, I have this Zutter Distress It All. And I really love it for when I'm doing huge projects like mini albums and stuff. But when I'm doing something small and it only involves like one sheet of like paper or one thing that I'm going to distress, I use this. And I buy it at the dollar store in the bath and beauty section or whatever. And it's like one of the pedicure thingies, but this one is dedicated only to my craft room, and I love the way it distresses my edges, especially this pumice stone right here. You could tell I use it a lot. And then you brush like the brush works, and then this works really good. Like, they sell these things for crafting for like $8-9, and I'm like, okay, well, it's the same exact thing as we use to scrub our feet, so let's try that. And it really works, and I love it. And so I'd recommend this if you're like on a budget and you don't want to go out and buy like one of them expensive distressing tools. This works awesome. So that's my tip for the day. But anyways, that's how I distressed all my edges, like around. That's what I used to distress my edges. So anyways, there's final look. Thank you guys for looking, and I will see you in the next video. Toodles!